My colleagues and I at Cal State Fullerton and in the LIGO Scientific Collaboration have just made the first direct detection of gravitational waves.
We have not only verified this fundamental prediction of a 100-year-old physical theory that governs the deepest way we think about gravity, but we've used this fundamental property of general relativity to open a new window on an entire array of objects in the universe that were entirely invisible to us before this point.
Einstein did understand that his theory predicted gravitational waves. He did accept that, but he thought that there's no chance we'll be able to measure them because their effect is so small.
Gravitational waves are a completely different type of wave. They're caused not by electricity and magnetism, but by the motion of mass. And they are carried through the universe as the stretching and squeezing of space-time. Space-time coming from Einstein's general relativity.
If you think of them as ripples on a pond, instead of a rock falling in a pond, you have black holes spiraling around each other and smashing into each other and merging to make a new big black hole. If you were clever enough at looking at the pattern of those ripples, you could figure out what the rock looked like, how massive it was, what it was doing when it hit the water. And we want to try to do the same kind of thing with gravitational waves and look at the ripples to try to find out about the things that cause them, even if, like, if they're black holes, they're totally invisible.
So LIGO is the Laser Interferometer Gravitational Wave Observatory. Those are two physical sites, one in Hanford, Washington, one in Livingston, Louisiana. Enormous structures built in the U.S. designed to detect gravitational waves.
The best hope of measuring gravitational waves comes from the loudest things we can think of, the most violent events anywhere in the universe. Things like black holes crashing into each other or stars exploding.
So if a gravitational wave from a faraway binary black hole system passes through Earth, the arms of our detector will stretch and squeeze as the gravitational wave passes. And we measure this as a change in the amount of light that falls on a photodetector at the output of the detector. And so we would see, if the wave was undulating like this, we'd see the same sort of undulations encoded into the light at the output of the detector.
This kind of fundamental physics is often something that we have no idea how it'll affect our lives for a long time.
Every other time we've seen in a new kind of light, like X-rays or microwaves, there's been some things that we expected, but there's been some stuff we had no idea until we could look. Being able to detect gravitational waves is kind of like no longer being deaf to the universe.
You can speculate that as gravitational wave astronomy becomes a field of observational astronomy, we will learn more about how black holes, stars, and galaxies have formed and evolved, how planets can be produced, giving us a better picture of how our lives fit into the context of the universe as a whole.